How are you doing, guys? I just wanted to bring your attention to this report recently published in The Lancet from the Global Burden of Disease Diet Collaborators. It's the most recent report from this ongoing observational study and the interpretation and recommendations from the researchers based on their findings. If you've been following my channel for a while, the results won't surprise you. I'm always bringing up data from the GBD study. In this report, the researchers iterate all the important findings from the study, emphasizing in particular the startling finding that a suboptimal diet now kills more people than smoking, high blood pressure, or indeed any other risk factor, highlighting the urgent need for improving human diet across nations. They remark that unlike many other risk factors, dietary risks are equal opportunity killers, affecting people regardless of age and so on. Arguably, the most important finding in the report is that of all diet-related cases, just three single dietary risk factors contribute to a whopping 50% of the deaths and 66% of the disability-adjusted life years globally: low intake of whole grains, low intake of fruit, and high intake of salt. The rest was attributed to all the usual stuff: high consumption of red and processed meat, sugar-sweetened beverages, trans fats, and so on. What is new in this report, however, is what the researchers recommend we do with these findings. They stress the need to do better to highlight the importance of consumption of healthy foods more so than simply avoiding unhealthy foods based on this data. Particularly, they propose the need to alter public health diet policy from the perennial recommendations to avoid salt, sugar, and fat, and put more emphasis instead on healthy foods we should be striving to maximize: whole grains, fruits, nuts, seeds, vegetables, and omega-3 fatty acids. To do this, they recommend nothing short of the urgent development of completely new food system interventions, since what we have is clearly not working. Luckily though for you watching this video right now, this message is totally aligned with what I am promoting on this channel, and here you'll find tips on simple ways to incorporate these foods into your diet right away. I'll link my healthy eating and omega-3 supplement playlists in the description box below, so check them out if that interests you. So overall, this report concurs with all the other high-profile studies on diet published recently. Substitution of whole plant foods in place of animal products and processed foods is good for our health. Indeed, the researchers acknowledge that the effect of individual dietary risks depends on the other components for which it is substituted, indicating that part of the benefits of whole plant foods may be due to this displacement of less healthy foods. Either way, the message is the same. So to summarize, the overall recommendations on diet remain unchanged: more whole plant foods and less animal products and processed foods for good health. What's new is the specific contribution from certain foods and the need to change public health policies to reflect these findings. The importance of moving from a reduce salt, sugar, and fat mantra to an increase whole plant foods approach. Thanks for watching. Hope you found the video informative. If you have any questions or comments, post them in the comment section below and I'll get back to you. I've got loads of good stuff on supplementation and nutrients of concern coming up, so make sure you subscribe if you haven't already so you don't miss out. That's it for now though. Talk to you next time. Sláinte.